Please see the link in the description if you wish to download a free video worksheet on kinetic and potential energy. Experiments can be dangerous. If you are a child, never do experiments unless your parent, guardian, or adult educator says it's all right and is there with you the whole time. Whenever any person, any animal, or anything is moving, we say it has kinetic energy. For simplicity, we call whatever is moving a body, even if it's an object. Kinetic energy is the energy of motion. Some bodies have more kinetic energy than others. We can think of the amount of kinetic energy a body has as the amount of energy we would need to put into that body to take it from not moving to having its current speed. This toy train has far less kinetic energy than a real train. The amount of kinetic energy a body has depends on the body's mass, what we commonly call its weight, and its velocity, what we commonly call its speed. Since this is an introductory video, we'll use the common words of weight and speed, but in more advanced videos on this topic, we'll use the scientific words of mass and velocity. The amount of kinetic energy a body has does not depend on what type of body it is or the direction it's moving. For example, it makes no difference whether the body is a rocket going up, a ship moving sideways, a train going backwards, or a person walking forwards. The amount of kinetic energy a body has only depends on the body's weight and its speed. The amount of kinetic energy a body has does not depend on what caused that body to move. For example, it makes no difference if that body is moving due to its own muscles, the muscles of another body, like when a ball is kicked by someone, using its own motors, being pushed by something else that has motors, like this barge is being pushed, or is being pushed by the wind. As soon as a body starts to move, then it has kinetic energy, and the amount of kinetic energy a body has only depends on the body's weight and its speed. If two bodies are moving at the same speed, like this truck and the blue car behind it, then the heavier body has more kinetic energy than the lighter body. These mothers and their calves are swimming at the same speed, but the mothers are heavier, so they have more kinetic energy than their calves. If a body is not moving, then it has no kinetic energy. But the faster it goes, then the more kinetic energy it has, as shown by this dog playing catch. Very few people want to do what this rock climber is doing, because we all get a gut feeling that if we slip, it is more dangerous to fall from hundreds of feet above the ground than from 2 feet above the ground. The reason it is more dangerous to fall from greater heights is because the longer we fall, the faster we fall. This person is jumping from more than 30 feet above the water. Please notice how his speed, as shown in miles per hour, continues to increase. Unless there is significant air resistance slowing the body down, it will continue to accelerate as it falls. Since increasing speed increases kinetic energy, the longer a body falls, the greater its kinetic energy becomes. All animals have instincts that tell them falling from great heights is dangerous. That's why most of us have a healthy fear of heights. If we know the height of a possible fall, then we can calculate the maximum kinetic energy a body will have at the end of that fall. The name for that predicted calculation is called the potential energy. Since this person's jump is much shorter than the prior person's jump, his potential energy is much less. This cat wants to get to the floor. If it chooses to do this in one step, it will have a large potential energy for that fall, which will cause a fast landing speed and a large amount of kinetic energy on its body, which could be harmful. Or the cat can choose to get down in 2 steps. The first step is a small height, so has a small potential energy for that fall, which will cause a slow landing speed on the keyboard and a small amount of kinetic energy. Once it lands on the keyboard, it resets its vertical speed to 0. Likewise, the second step has a small height, so has a small potential energy from that fall, which will cause a slow landing speed and a small amount of kinetic energy on the cat's body when it lands on the floor. The cat instinctively makes the safer choice, so its landing speed for each step is slower, and it has a lower risk of injury. Like kinetic energy, the amount of potential energy a body has also depends on the mass of the body. These candies are light and are falling only a short distance, so they have very little potential energy before they fall. In contrast, even though these rocks are also falling a short distance, because each rock is heavier than each piece of candy, each rock has more potential energy. When those rocks fall, each will have more kinetic energy than a piece of candy, so can do more damage, such as if they fell on something fragile. That's why, if something heavy falls, it can have enough kinetic energy to damage a wooden floor, even if it only falls a few inches. At the top of this cliff, these ladies have a lot of potential energy, but no vertical kinetic energy. When they fall, they change their potential energy into kinetic energy. So by the time they splash into the water, they have no more potential energy, but they have a lot of kinetic energy. This photo sequence shows a lady's potential energy as though she had made multiple steps, like the cat getting down from the piano. Potential energy can be calculated based on the current height above the landing place, and this updates constantly. Here is the kinetic energy she has during each of these photos. Unlike the potential energy that is only calculated based on her current height, the kinetic energy is calculated based on her speed, which increases as she falls. As the potential energy decreases, the kinetic energy increases. Potential energy is being changed to kinetic energy. Here is an energy change that is the opposite of a falling body. This skater has a lot of kinetic energy and changes all of it into potential energy by going up a ramp. This skateboarder is also changing his kinetic energy into potential energy. But his kinetic energy, which is his forward speed, is not entirely changed to potential energy. So he continues to go forwards after going up the ramp. This train starts at the top of a hill, so it has a lot of potential energy, but it has only a little kinetic energy since it is barely moving. By the time it reaches the bottom of the first hill, the train has changed all of its potential energy into kinetic energy. Potential energy and kinetic energy are trade-offs. The more you have of one, the less you have of the other. A roller coaster train is the classic example for changing potential to kinetic energy and back to potential energy as it goes down and up hills. Pendulums like this, or anything that swings, also change kinetic energy into potential energy, and then they change the potential energy back to kinetic energy. These energy changes happen with every cycle. When the ball is at an end of a cycle, it has a lot of potential energy but has no kinetic energy. When the ball has swung to the bottom of a cycle, it has changed all of its potential energy into kinetic energy. And finally, when the ball gets to the other end of the cycle, it has regained its full potential energy but has lost all of its kinetic energy. Kinetic and potential energy play a large role in engineering and technology. Whenever we are thinking of how we are going to power a vehicle, whether that is choosing motors or designing a new one, we have to know how much kinetic energy the vehicle will have when it's moving. This applies to everything from boats to rockets. We can make electrical energy by harnessing the power of falling water. This is what hydroelectric plants do. At the top of the dam, the water has a lot of potential energy. As the water falls, its potential energy is changed into kinetic energy, which just means the water is flowing. That flowing water spins a large rotor on a machine called a turbine, which converts kinetic energy into electrical energy. That electrical energy connects to the electrical grid, so we can use that electrical energy to power anything we plug into a wall outlet, as well as many things around us, including city lights. Here's a summary of what we've covered in this introduction to kinetic energy and gravitational potential energy. Please pause this video if you wish.